Welcome to Mind Over Matter, baby. Yes, sir. Welcome back to another episode of Mind Over Matter, baby. I'm your host, DEJA Wallace, and if this is your first time joining me, welcome. If this is not your first time joining me, shout out to you. Thank you so much for tuning into the podcast, and let's get right into it. On today's episode, I'm going to be talking about S-E-X. Sex.
Come on. Let's talk about sex, baby. Let's talk about you and me. Let's talk about all the good things and the bad things that may be. Let's talk about sex. Let's talk about sex. Let's talk about sex. Let's talk about sex.
Let's talk about sex for now. To the people at home or in the crowd, it keeps coming up anyhow. Don't decoy, avoid, or make void the topic,
cause that ain't gonna stop it.
Now, just talk about sex on the radio and video shows.
Many will know.
Anything goes. Let's tell it like it is and how it could be. How it was and of course how it should be. Those who think it's dirty have a choice. Pick up the needle, press pause, or turn the radio off. Will that stop us, Pat?
I doubt it.
Alright then, come on, spin.
Let's talk about sex. Let's talk about sex. Let's talk about sex. Let's talk about sex.
Hot to try.
Now the dance moves in this video really got it. You have to go and tune into the video because like the dance moves, they were going crazy. But yeah, that was Salt and Pepper, Let's Talk About Sex. And I just discovered this song like yesterday because you know the song that goes, let's talk about you and me. I think it's a Neo song. Let's talk about. I guess it was a sample from this, y'all. You learn something new every day. But yeah, I didn't know this song until like yesterday. And that song bumps. My mom probably was back in the day in the club like, let's talk about sex. And it had me. But yeah, anyways. Welcome to another episode, episode 36 of Mind Over Matter, baby. So on today's episode, I'll be talking about sex, like I said before. I'll be talking about the stigma of sex, like talking about sex amongst females. I'll be talking about just my experience with sex, being a virgin. I'll also talk about just like how sex is looked at in the black culture as a whole and just dating in your 20s, online dating apps. Yeah, I'm talking about all of that on today's episode of Mind Over Matter, baby. So kick back, relax, and enjoy this episode. Okay, so I only got like 30 minutes to record this, so I'm gonna get right to the point, guys. Where do I even start? Like, all right, I'm gonna start from the beginning. Growing up in a Caribbean household, a lot of you guys may be able to relate, especially if you're a female, because don't really talk about sex that much, especially when you're a female. My personal experience growing up, like, till this day, my dad is going to change the radio if he hears the word sex on it, or if the it's something freaky, if they're talking about something freaky on the radio, he's changing it. Like, it's sad. Like, if I'm sitting down watching something and a kissing scene comes on and he walks in the room, he's changing the channel. Like, mind you, I'm 21. But that's just to give you, like, an overall feel of how it was growing up in my household. It was really not talked about at all. It was, like, forbidden. Like, it was always a silent knowledge that I knew I wasn't able to talk about it because they didn't talk about it. And that kind of made me grow up sheltered and very naive when it came to sex. And that's probably why it took me so long to even try it. But, yeah, it was just, it wasn't spoken about at all. And being the person I am, I'm very curious. So when I was younger, I did my own explorations, you get me? I'm not going to get into too much details. That could be saved for another episode. But I was very, very, very curious child, and I just never had the confidence to talk about that topic with my parents. And I didn't have a lot of female friends, and I didn't, like, I just clicked more with the guys. So what I heard about sex was through, like, guys' perspective. So growing up, I kind of adopted that kind of perspective about sex, and I still have that kind of perspective about sex, which isn't, it's kind of toxic, the way guys look at sex, the ones I hung around. But I kind of touched more into depth about this in my double standards episode, so you could go back and listen to that if you want me to get into more details. But I just want to talk about the overall, like, stigma of sex that I experienced. Like, even a lot of females, they feel like they can't comfortably talk about their sex lives outside of their small friend group or outside of the selected few people they feel comfortable talking about it with. But guys don't care. They say whatever they want, however they want, and they don't care how it's looked at. And I wish females could switch that narrative a little more to just talk about it freely and not feel like a dirty, like, they're whores. I just want to talk about my experience now. Now that y'all know a little background on how I grew up. So sex was really shunned in my household. Didn't talk about it, you know, at all. And that kind of made me grow up not really thinking about it in a realistic light, because what I was taught about sex is what I heard from the guys around me, seen on TV, and yeah, that's pretty much it, and heard on songs. That's pretty much how I learned about it. And it's not really a realistic expectation. But that's how it was taught to me because, like I said, it wasn't spoken about. So I learned about it by myself, you know, even on porn. Like, and that's a whole different topic, that whole just cycle of porn, like how unrealistic it is. But that's a whole different topic. So my just idea of it was very, very toxic and very just unrealistic. So that's how I moved throughout life with that knowledge of what, yeah. So moving on, when I went to college now, not even college, let's start from high school, because people were having sex in high school. A lot of people were having sex in high school. It kind of made me, not talking about it kind of made me a prude in high school. When my friends were talking about it, I got really, like, awkward, or I wouldn't even speak. I wouldn't even add my two cents to the conversation because I felt like I had nothing to say because I wasn't having it. So I would, like, exclude myself from the conversation without even being excluded. Like, I already dismissed myself. I'm like, oh, y'all talking about that? I'm not going to say nothing. Like, y'all got it this conversation is yours. And I kind of just didn't talk about it. And when other people spoke about it, it kind of made me feel a way. It kind of made me feel like, damn, that sounds great. Why am I not having it? And it made me very curious. Like, that was around 16. And in a way, not talking about it made me kind of insecure and not embrace my sensuality. And when I say that, I mean, I wasn't very tapped in with my femininity at that age because I kind of neglected just my sexual essence, if that makes sense. If you get me, you get me. But that kind of made me move more masculine in a way in high school. So I kind of just pretended I didn't have emotions in a way when it came to that topic. So I would just shut down and not say anything when it came to sex. And moving forward, like in college, I started to realize that I kind of made myself very insecure in a way because I didn't really talk about it and I didn't really express how I felt towards guys because it was always on a friendly level. So anytime I spoke to a guy off rip, they vibed with me on like just a friend level. They looked at me like the bro, like, Deja, that's the bro, what? And that used to hurt my ego, especially hearing that from guys you really like. Like, yeah. So that continued all throughout college, you know. For the first 2 years especially, guys really looked at me like, oh, that's the bro, Deja, that's the bro, that's the sis, she's cool, she's cool. They used to kill me with that in college. But you know how bad it was? Sometimes I'll be chilling in my dorm room. Some guy I'm feeling would, like, pull up, but he doesn't know I'm feeling him. And they will fall asleep in my room. No action, nada. Just fall asleep. And this happened on multiple occasions with different guys. Like, they will fall asleep in my room, nada, nothing, zilch, nothing. And I would think to myself, like, is there something wrong with me? Am I ugly? Because ain't no way, boy, ain't no way. Boy, ain't no way. But they just see me as a friend. And I'm the type of person, especially like what I told you before, I'm not going to initiate sex. I'm just going to go to sleep. If we're in the bed, I'm probably going to go to sleep. Unless you're trying to get crazy, that we could get crazy, but it never happened. So, yeah, I would just be in the bed like, damn, am I ugly? Like, why nobody want me? And a lot of girls feel like they have to, a lot of girls feel like they get their worth from men, and especially at younger ages, like, you know, 18, I was around 18 19, so I definitely was looking at men as a way to say I'm valuable, like, oh, he desires me, so I'm actually attractive. And that's kind of my, that was my mindset at the time. And my mindset kind of shifted after my first sexual experience. And this is why I wish us women had more people to talk to when it came to sex, because then we wouldn't make these poor decisions. So I'm about to tell y'all a quick story of how I lost it, all right? I'm sorry, mom and dad. I'm sorry. I'm sorry if y'all listening to this. It's going to be hard to listen to, but you know, I'm gonna say, all right, so boom. I went on Tinder, right? Because I honestly became sexually frustrated with even without even having sex. I never had the experience, but I was becoming sexually frustrated, and I'm like, damn. Like, I kind of want to be able to experience this so sensational thing. Everybody's having it, right? Like, it's cool. Like, it was kind of for social inclusion, too, which I'm going to get to later on in this episode. But it was kind of for social inclusion. I kind of wanted to have sex, but mostly for the experience. So I went on Tinder. Off rip, like, like off the rip. Before I even decided to download Tinder, like, I already had that kind of image in my head, like, Tinder is for desperate people looking for hookups. That's kind of wasn't my idea of what dating apps were. It's for desperate people that are lonely. That was my idea of what Tinder and dating apps were. So I went against all my beliefs, and I was like, you know what? I'm tired of this shit. Let me just download it and see what's up. Maybe I'm not being open-minded enough. Like, maybe I could really find a deep, meaningful connection on there.
Meet me tonight.
Stop the cap.
Yeah, I lied to myself. But I downloaded the app, and within like 3 days, like, my inbox is blowing up, right? I had like just this plethora of men. It was like perfect amount of just black excellence on that app, bro. Like, it's literally like you could pick and choose. It's like pick a nigga, you know, like build a bear. It's like build a nigga. But yeah, anyways, it was like Amazon for men. But I finally found somebody that I thought was cute, you know, and we was going back and forth for a little, talking a little, and then it came to the point where he wanted to link up. And I was like, all right, let's link up, you know. I linked up with him. We Netflix and chilled, like the kids say. And, you know, it came time to, you know, warm up the oven before you put the food in. You get me? So I had to test the food out. Ooh, this is a good analogy. I had to test the food out, right? So I sniffed the food. It didn't smell anyway, you know. Then I decided to just taste it. Like, let me just taste it. So I tasted it. When I say one piece of nastiness licked my tongue, sheesh, I didn't know God can make something so natural taste so bad. I wouldn't wish it on my worst enemy. It was the worst, most sour, most disgusting thing that ever touched my taste buds. It was nasty. It was nastiness. Like, I didn't know something could taste so meh. It was disgusting. It was thinking back to it now, like, I want to throw up when I think about it. But it was horrible. It was like, and the bad thing is it didn't have a smell. So it was a setup. Like, it was just a setup. Like, it was just a bad experience. But the actual sex was okay. I feel like he could have done better. And that's sad because I was a virgin at the time, and I'm still critiquing you like this. But I told him, after I told him I was a virgin, he got better, and it ended up being okay. Like, it was, like, good. It was way better than how he started after I told him that I was a virgin. But all that being said, right, I don't regret that experience because it made me learn a lot. It made me learn that I should have stayed my ass a virgin. And for all my females that feel pressured by society or by even music, because, like, a lot of times I would hear certain songs about, you know, like the Meg Stallions, the Cardi B's, about just being very promiscuous for your man or just being very sexual. You don't have to know your worth, you know? Do that for men who deserve it. Because I'm not going to lie, I definitely compromised with my standards that day, and I lowered my standards that day to deal with this guy. And I'm telling you from personal experience, now I lost it through a one-night stand on Tinder. But anyways, don't judge me, y'all. I'm really trying to be transparent so y'all don't make the mistake I made. You know, poor decisions. But what I took away from that is, in the Black culture, like, especially rap music, when you're listening to these songs, it gives you, like, this unrealistic expectation of how sex should be, even on social media, and even, like, listening to certain, you know, immature friends, it gives you, like, this unrealistic expectation of how sex should be. And I kind of felt that through my first experience, because he wasn't gentle at all. He wasn't reassuring. He didn't care about me. He didn't. That's the like real truth. Like, ladies, especially if you're in your 20s, going into this dating world, just be careful. Think it through. Don't just go off your emotions, because I had a long day that day, and it was a bad, like, very bad day for me. And I kind of wanted to, you know, and when you're having a bad day, why not top it off with a bad decision? Guys in this generation, a lot of them look at you as an object. And they literally just look at women as a hobby. They look at sex as a hobby, honestly. And it's just something to do in your free time for them. And that's cool if y'all both on the same timing. But all I have to say is, when you're dating, make sure that person knows all your intentions, and make sure you know your partner's intentions in that relationships, because then y'all can work off of something real. A lot of us go in with false expectations, unrealistic expectations, and we don't voice how we feel and our intentions. Oftentimes our needs aren't met in that relationships, and it just doesn't fill the void we thought it would. And that's really what I learned from that experience, is now moving forward, I would never, ever, ever compromise with my worth. And that guy got really lucky. He got really lucky that I was in that vulnerable state in my life. And I just want a lot of y'all females to wake up and realize you're the prize. You're the gift. Pussy runs the world. Pussy is power. Stop letting these guys dictate how you feel about yourself and how worthy you are and how beautiful you feel. That's really what I learned from that experience. It's really a ruthless world. It's a crazy world. Like, I realized that some guys will really say anything and manipulate you to get what they want. So make sure you stand 10 toes down, stay strong. You know, this dating world is not easy right now, especially like this whole online dating paradigm is old. It's like it's OD. It's crazy. But like I said, just know what you want to get out of that relationship and make sure that person needs is also voiced. And don't move out of sexual frustration. And it's okay to talk about sex. It doesn't make you a dirty slut or a thot or a hoe. Because after that experience, I knew I was programmed to think like that, because I was literally in my bed like, yo, why did I do that? Like, I'm so nasty. I'm so disgusting. I'm so, like, I can't even look at myself in the mirror. Why would I do that? Like, I really went through with that after it tasted like that. But I'm here to tell you there's nothing wrong with sex. And just do it with somebody you're comfortable with, you know? Because me, as in the very emotional person I am, it was very hard for me to fully enjoy it because I just had no connection with that person. So try to find somebody you're comfortable with and you trust and you know that they're going to respect your needs. And yeah, just it's okay to date too. Like, you don't have to do, because I'm not even gonna lie, even though I woke up that morning with dick on my mind and I was very sexually frustrated, when the moment came, I kind of didn't want to do it after I tasted that. But I kind of forced myself to do it. I'm not going to lie. I kind of forced myself to say yes. And don't be like me. Don't be like me, ladies. Do not be like me. That was a very dumb decision. Listen to your intuition when it comes to these men, because it's most likely right. If he's giving you a red flag and your gut just doesn't feel like it just doesn't sit right with it, don't give up your energy to him, because at the end of the day, when you're having sex, you're transferring energies. And if you guys both aren't in tune, one person could walk away fine and leave the other person feeling miserable. Why? Because it's a transfer of energy. That person could have been dealing with something very dark and very just deep, just very something very just dark in his life. And he could have now transferred that to you. So that's why I say pick your partners very, very wisely when you're having sex, because it's literally a transfer of energy. And that goes for guys too. Guys, these females could really take your energy. And you're wondering, damn, why do I feel like this today? I feel crazy. I don't know why I feel so sad. Because you were dealing with a girl that was depressed. And you don't even know why you're feeling sad now. So yeah, just keep that in mind. Like, it's a very intimate act. And don't let, like, these rappers or just hip-hop culture fool you. Sex is intimate. It has emotions in it. Even if you want to turn off your emotions for all the thug niggas, like all the thugs that be trying to feel like, oh, she's just a kill. Karma's real. Karma's real. And it may not play out right away, but your child could see the effects of you just doing women dirty. And yeah, just keep all of that in mind. Like, sex is not a sport. It's something that should be taken seriously. And it's fun. Don't get me wrong, it's fun. But also know, there's sex addicts out there, you know? that's when it don't get fun anymore, right? Now it's serious. Now it's serious. Now you wish you wore the condom, huh? Exactly. But yeah, I just kind of wanted to express this. This was not an easy topic to do at all. Like I said, there's a very strong stigma in my community about just females talking about sex. Yeah, this was not an easy topic to do. And, let's just talk about, like, fucking versus making love, right? A lot of guys, young guys especially, a lot of young guys, they have sex with females, and it's not even sex. It's just to get a nut off. And it's for selfish intentions. It's for their own intentions. They don't care about you. That's why I'm telling you, make sure you know what that guy's intentions are beforehand. And make sure you're going off of how you feel about him, not anybody else. Because your intuition never lies. And if you're having second thoughts, it's probably a reason you're having second thoughts about it. Because that guy is probably trying to manipulate you into having sex and telling you all the sweet things you want to hear. But just keep a strong mental, you know? Keep that strong mental. Because a lot of women do fold, and I'm not gonna be one of them again. Because I did fold. I'm not going to lie. I folded, but yeah, it made for a good podcast episode, right? but yeah, that's really all I have to say, and that's it. So thank you if you listen to the end of another episode. I'm sorry, Mom. Sorry, Dad, if you had to listen to this, but it's my truth, and I'm speaking it, and I feel like I want to be more transparent with you guys on this podcast about my experiences and what I've taken from it, and yeah, my whole mentality about sex has changed. Like, now, it's lit, you know? Dating is fun, don't get me wrong. Like, dating is really fun. If you 6'4" and up, you know. Hit your girl up. But yeah, this is another end of another episode. Thank you so much for listening to the end. And don't forget to tell a friend to tell a friend to tell a friend, moms. That is mind over matter, baby.